Hi Template, it's me, Emily Seebohm, Australian Olympic swimmer, and I'm heading into the jungle. But before I do, I have some questions to answer. I don't take myself like too seriously, so I feel like it's just gonna be fun, lighthearted. I mean, I have three brothers, so everything in life has always been kind of a game or a challenge or, you know, pushing my way through. So I think with that, I know I'm good, but with all the bugs and stuff, I don't know how good I will be at that, but I will definitely try my hardest. I won't lie, I've never camped before in my life and it doesn't really interest me, but in terms of like being in a camp with other people, like I really think that's something that I would enjoy because I've been on the Australian team since I was 14, so I've been around a lot of people my whole life. So I feel like for that, I'm really excited to get to know people and how we found ourselves to be in this situation and where we're gonna go from here. The food situation in camp is going to be a little bit interesting. I don't eat, is it porridge or oats for breakfast? Like either way, I don't eat that normally. So that will be interesting. I don't really cook it either, so I wouldn't even know where to start with that. Rice and beans don't bother me. I've eaten lots of rice and beans are beans, like whatever. I'm not a chef at all. Like my partner says that I cook just to stay alive really. And yeah, I do just to stay alive. Fingers crossed there is actually a chef in there. That's what I told my parents because I didn't want to cook anything and they were very worried that I would not survive if there wasn't a chef in there. So yeah, let's pray. Yeah, well, obviously the number one person I want to see is a chef. but apart from that, I think someone funny, like I just want to have like barrels of laughs and I think like I really like someone that I can bounce off with like conversations and things that flow easy. Like I feel like I'm a very open book. So if I get someone that just wants to chat, then I will literally tell my life story and it won't bother me. I feel like most trials I'll be okay with. If they're a challenge, then I am up for a challenge because I feel like I've pushed my body so far in my career that that won't really bother me too much. I think the one trial that I would really, really hate is that one where they're like buried underground and then the snakes come out. And yeah, that one, like that, I would probably be like crying into my goggles. As for fears, I don't really know. I'm very much that type of person that will do anything once. So like, you know, I don't love heights, but it's not a massive fear of mine. Like I've jumped off like a 10 meter diving platform before, that doesn't bother me. You know, for my dad's 50th, we got him skydiving and he didn't want to go by himself. And I was the only one that said that they would do it. And like, I was terrified, but I did it. And it like wasn't, I was never not gonna do it, but I was sitting there like terrified. I was like, oh my God, I'm gonna die. I guess what I wanna get from the jungle is just really being myself and people kind of knowing more about me. I think from my swimming career, people know a little bit about me, but they don't know a lot. So I guess it's about opening up to people and really connecting to other people as well. Like I feel like I have so much knowledge and so much experience over my career, even though I'm only 29. I feel like the person that comes out of the jungle will probably have things to tell me before I head in. They'll be like, oh, it was fine. You loved it. You had so much fun. I don't know if there's anything that I can tell myself now that in 3 weeks time, I'm gonna be like, that's exactly what you thought it was gonna be. But I also think that I'm just gonna have a lot of fun. And if I go in there thinking that, then I'm manifesting it, right? So it's gonna happen. So yeah, you're just gonna have so much fun and nothing's gonna be horrible at all.